Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making another recipe from 815 Prime in Midway, Kentucky, because we had two complete meals each, and so we had a lot of things to choose from. And I've been working on the two things that I ordered, so we've already completed the whole meal that was bacon, lettuce, tomato sandwich with chipotle, mayonnaise, and Monterey Jack cheese. And then we put with that some home fried potato chips. And we used the white potato and cut it crosswise. And that was very hard to do, so we got some little thin slivers and then we did some rounds. But what we're doing today is an accompaniment to go with our previous upload, which was another sandwich that was inspired by 815 Prime. And that sandwich was the tarragon chicken salad sandwich. So you've seen that probably. And if you want the accompaniment for that, it was sweet potato chips. So right here, I have a sweet potato just as an example. And I noticed that they had the red type. And you can see when you peel them and work with them, they're very dark orange, but we call these red sweet potatoes. You can get white sweet potatoes or red sweet potatoes, and it really doesn't matter for this recipe, but I'm trying to make this as much like what we had on our little lunch out as possible. So this is part of it. I peeled it completely with a parer on the outside. However, the other day when I was working with the white potatoes, I didn't peel those. I just left the skin on because I'm very familiar with eating the skin of a white potato, and a lot of the nutrients are close to the skin. It is actually good. So I don't know that people necessarily like the skin of a sweet potato. So we're taking that off. And then, as you recall, when you try to do these slices crosswise and you're using a parer to do it, you cut it in the middle or something and just try going like that, it's very hard because it's not very big around. But if you go lengthwise like this, you can get a nice sliver. Actually, you can come up the other direction probably and get it better. But we have a plate full of slivers here. With only using about almost half of one sweet potato. So they're ready to be fried. I've got my peanut oil over here. And actually I'm using the same oil that I used on the white potatoes. I have a quick tip on saving oil if you want to look that up, because I firmly believe in using the oil more than once unless you put something that taints the oil. If it's something that is going to give it a real fishy smell or something like that, then I will either try to freshen it by using white potatoes and frying some in there, or I will just kind of say it's time to get rid of that oil. Let's start again with a fresh bunch. And I always put about an inch or so if I'm deep frying. And I've got this hot, but it's probably cooled down since I've talked a little bit. So I'm going to go away and get it right at 350 degrees before I come back and fry those sweet potatoes. So we're right at 350 degrees and I have brought over my sweet potato slices. And what I'm going to do is drop them in. And I have a utensil for tending them. It won't take long for these to fry up. They're very thin, thinner than the rounds that we had the other day. And also, I have a plate ready to receive them. So there's a paper towel on here for draining, and I like to blot the top, so that's what that is for. And also, I've got some sea salt, and this time I'm going to grind it on instead of putting the whole little chunk of salt. I think it'll be better if we grind it on. So here's what it looks like when one piece goes in. And I'll try to let them get ahead of one another enough that they won't stick together. If they get that little bit of frying first, then that kind of protects them from the others. But we'll just kind of cover the top there. And they'll pretty much take care of themselves. And it will be pretty obvious when they're done. If we need to turn them over, then we'll take care of that with this utensil. Just let them float around a little bit. I'm just doing a small amount this time. I think I'll turn this down a little bit. But I'll just keep doing different batches. Some of these are getting a a little over brown, but most of them are just about right. So we don't want that to smoke. So I think I was just letting it get a little too hot. Here's what we have for our first bunch. We'll probably do better on the second bunch. I think that's okay. Let me turn it down. I'll turn it off for now and tell you what I would do with these that are done. A little bit brown and crusty on a couple of them, and that's just because they went in at different times. I could have done one at a time and they would be perfect, but of course we're not going to do that. So I've blotted off the top a little bit, so I'm just going to use my sea salt shaker or grinder and go around, and it makes finer grinding, but it is still coarse salt instead of table salt. So it's going to taste really good when we get them done. So I'll get back to frying and I'll have a whole set of these in just a minute. I finished frying almost half of one sweet potato, and here's what we have. These have been salted because they were taken out in groups about like this and patted down and salted while they were still hot. This group has not been salted, so I'll just give it a little bit of salt. Now, you know, you could use sugar if you like a sweet flavor on this, because they are sweet potatoes and they do go well with sugar. You could use brown sugar if you like that. But I'm trying to stay fairly true to the recipe that we ate on our little lunch out. So here we have our sweet potato chips, and I hope you like them. I want to take a bite of the sweet potato chips for you. So I've just picked up one here. Lost a little bit of it, but you can hear that it's very crisp, very crunchy, very good. Don't salt it too much because I can taste the salt pretty prevalently because I really went over the top. But remember, just a little will be enough on these. They're really nice and sweet. I like that about them. But then that little bit of salt is really good too. I'm going to put a portion over here on a plate that we prepared earlier today, which was one of the sandwiches. That's actually the tarragon chicken salad. And each of our sandwich plates was served with a dill pickle spear at the side. So that's just out of a jar from the refrigerator, so I'm not going to take a bite of that, but we'll dress up our sandwich by putting the appropriate type of chip with it, which is the sweet potato chip. And I hope you enjoy the whole meal.